Talk about how you can play a song called Centuries by Fall Out Boy. And there's this cool little quote at the very beginning. If you wanted to kind of follow those notes, you could play 2nd fret on the D, 4th fret on the D, open G, open B, and then back to 2nd on the D, 4th on the D, open G, open B, and then 2nd on the D, open B, 2nd on the G, open G, 2nd on the G, open G, on the G, open G. So if you wanted to kind of follow those notes, you could kind of go E, F sharp, G, B, E, F sharp, G, B, E, B, A, G, A, G, A, G. Be kind of cool. And around that, if you wanted to back that up with a chord, you'd start on an E minor chord. And normally you do this first finger on the A second, second finger on the D second. And if you strum all those together, it sounds an E minor chord and it sounds really sad. You may also want to think about adding a third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third, and kind of working that for the E minor, so kind of an E minor 7. Or if you just want to rock this out, you could kind of work it as an E5 power chord, working open E and A string 2nd. Or you may want to go to 7th fret on the A, 3rd finger on the D 7th or 9th fret. You kind of work that for your E5. And then from the E minor, actually on that first part, actually, you may want to just back that up with just the chord. So you could kind of work just that E minor with kind of a down idea, kind of for that intro. Or you could use a strum pattern. And one of my favorite strum patterns for a 4-4 like this is down, down, up, up, down, up. So took the E minor and just tried that a lot. Yeah, down. Myself, especially, but when the verse and the chorus kind of kicks in, you may gravitate towards the 16th note strum pattern. And what I mean by that is if you're tapping your foot to the beat, right now we're dividing that into two parts with our down, down, up, up, down, up. So kind of one, two, one, two, and that's called an eighth note. What a 16th note is where you divide that into four parts. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. And one of my favorite 16th note strum patterns is a long down, 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 up, up, down, down, up, down. And what I mean by that is if you take the E minor and do it down for 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's what you'd be doing on the first beat. And on the second beat, you do it down on 1, down on 3, up on 4. So we're going 1, 2, 3, 4, down, 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 down. And then on the third beat, you do it up on 2, down on 3. So kind of 1, 2, 3. But you go down, up, down, up, right along with the 1, 2, 3, 4. So all together, you got E minor, down, 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 kind of our main verse chorus, and you'll kind of hear this cool little lick in the piano part actually kind of playing 3rd on the high E string, 2nd fret on the high E, open E, and then open B, and that gets repeated actually through that phrase. 3-2-0-0, 3-2-0-0, 3-2-0-0, 3-2-0-0, 3-2-0-0, or G, F sharp, E, B is kind of that main lick. And you could even back that up with bass notes actually. Start with the low open E, and I'm kind of doing that hybrid picking, so I'm using my pick for the lick, or pick for the basses and fingers for the lick, so you may want to kind of experiment with that. And then you may want to do that same lick with 3rd on the low E string for the bass, and then with 3rd on the A string for the bass, and then with the open A for the bass, all that, like that could be kind of cool. It's kind of like an E idea. chords, kind of starting out on the E minor, and then we would go to a G major chord. And normally do this first finger on the A second, second finger on the low E third, third finger on the high E third. And if you strum all those together, all the beautiful sounds in G major. Now you may also dig on put the third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third, kind of working that from the G major. Or if you want to rock it out, you can use a G5 power chord by doing first finger on the low E third, third finger on the A fifth fret, kind of working that for your G5. And if from the G, we'd be going to a C major chord. I normally do this first finger on the B first fret, second finger on the D second, third finger on the A third. And if you strum the A string to the high E string, ah, the beautiful sounds of C major. Now you may also dig on lifting the first finger and make that a C major seven. Or adding in the pinky on the B third for a C major nine and kind of saying some stuff around the C chord. Or another way to play a C major nine is to do first finger on the D second, second finger on the A third, third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third. Kind of working that for a C major. Or if you just want to rock it out, you could use a C5 power chord. Doing first finger on the A third fret, third finger on the D fifth fret. Kind of working that for the C5. Or you may even dig on doing that from the low E string, kind of eighth fret on the low E, tenth fret on the A string for a C5. And from the C, we'd be going to an A minor chord. We normally do this first finger on the B first fret, second finger on the D second, third finger on the G second fret. And if you strum all those together, oh, the sad sounds of A minor. Now you may also dig on lifting the first finger, making that A sus2. We're adding in the pinky on the B string third for an A suspended, kind of saying some stuff around the A minor. Or you may dig on lifting off the third finger, making that an A minor 7. We're adding in the pinky on the high E third for an A minor 7. Or you may dig on an A7 sus by doing first finger on the D second, second finger on the G second, third finger on the B third, pinky on the high E third, kind of working that for the A minor. Or if you just want to rock it out, you can do an A5 power chord, doing an open A and the second fret on the B. Or you can do fifth fret on the low E, seventh fret on the A string for an A5. And then from the A, we'd be going to a D major chord. And normally you do this first finger on the G second, second finger on the high E second, third finger on the B third. And if you strum the D string to the high E string, ah, the beautiful sounds of D major. Now you may also dig on lifting the second finger, always a fun finger to lift. That makes a D suspended. Or you could add in the pinky on the high E third for D suspended, kind of say some stuff around the D chord. Or if you just want to rock it out, you could use the D5 power chord, kind of open D and second on the G string. Or you could go fifth fret on the A string, seventh fret on the D string for a D5. Working it that way. And through that part, if you're digging on the down idea, and there are definitely parts through the song that sound like this, you may want to do kind of an 8 down count on the E minor, and then 8 on the G. Eight on the C, and then kind of a four count on the A minor, and then four on the D. E minor, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, G, C, A minor, D. Or if you're doing the down, down, up, up, down, you can kind of work it as a really slow paced down, down, up, up, down, up. And when we get to the A minor D, you may want to do just half the pattern, kind of the down, down, up on each chord. Or if you're a little bit more adventurous, you can split the pattern. And you can do A minor with the down, down, up. And then go to the D for the up, down, up. Or sometimes I get excited, and I'll do the A minor with the down, down, and then hit the D for the up, up, down, up. So we tried it that way. Minor D, you may want to do the down, 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 up, kind of on each of those chords to kind of half them. Or if you're a little bit more adventurous, you do the A minor with the down, 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 up, down, down, up, and you go to the D for the up, down, down, down. times, and then we go into kind of like a break, actually. It's like our intro part. So you kind of hear that lick coming back. Kind of through that. So you could kind of ride it out on that lick, or if you just wanted to back that up with kind of the E minor chord, yeah, you could kind of work that with either one of those strumming ideas. Or something else that I like to add to a song like this, too, is bass notes. And a lot of times on that first down, of the down, down, up, up, down, up, you can throw in a bass note for the chord. So on the E minor, you have the low E string for the bass. And then on the G, you have low E for the bass. On the C, you have the A for the bass. On the A minor, you have the A for the bass. And on the D string, or on the D, you have the D for the bass. So we could work it as kind of a bass down, up, up kind of an idea. Kind of E minor bass, down, up. To that, and you can make it a bass down, down, up, down, down, up, down, or a bass, bass, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, or a bass, bass, down, down, up, bass, down, up, down. So you kind of dig on that, it's kind of that break. You kind of repeat that E minor for two bars, and then we go back into kind of our main progression. Now, one other thing that might be kind of cool, or the weird part about kind of working that bass down, up, on our main verse chorus. Is on the A minor D where they half, you may want to do a bass down up on each of those chords. Or you can kind of work the split pattern, kind of A minor with a bass down up, D with a up down up, or A minor with a bass down, and then hitting the D for the up, up down up. So we tried our main progression that way. You'd have the E minor, D, you may want to do a bass down, down, up on each of those chords. Or you can split the pattern and do the A minor with the bass down, down, up, and then go to the D for the up, bass down, down. So we tried it that way. You have E minor, G, C, A minor, D, E minor. Five times, and then we go back into kind of our E minor break, and you may want to bring back that lick kind of back on the E minor. Or actually something else that could be cool is you will hear these licks where you could kind of go 7th fret on the A string and then 5th fret on the A and then back to 7 on the A. And if you wanted to, you could almost work that like a chord hit, kind of E minor 7 5 7 7. Definitely hear spots in the chorus that kind of work that same way. So you can even make that big chord hits, kind of the E minor chord. G, C, A minor, D. On the A minor D, you won't hear quite as much. So you got E minor. Even kind of make that kind of an accent for yourself. Take all these ideas and kind of mix it up. So we tried that through that next verse chorus. We got the E minor, and going back into kind of our main lick, actually on the E minor. It's kind of the break idea. Or you will hear kind of this cool elaboration actually on that break, where you could kind of take the 7-5 idea we were doing on the A string and kind of just going back and forth between that E, D. Kind of on that E minor. So you could even kind of use that. If you kind of dig on that. And then from there, then we'll be going into our last verse chorus. Now what you may want to do together is kind of take all these ideas, kind of mix them up and kind of find out how you want to kind of cover the song, kind of make it your own tune. Or if you know other strum patterns or other legs, you may want to kind of play around with that. Definitely different ways to kind of take all these ideas and kind of weave them into how you're feeling too. On it anyway. But that's the basics of how you could strum through Centuries by Fall Out Boy. Good luck!